friends, I'm Dr. Asha Bakshi from Indore. I welcome you to this clinical question answer series. We all have some queries in our day-to-day practice. I hope this video series will help you solve some of these queries. Hi, my today's question is to Dr. Mansi Shukla. Mansi is young gynecologist from Indore. She is recipient of several gold medals and awards and is currently undergoing fellowship in fetal medicine. Mansi, you are doing fellowship in fetal medicine, so I think you are the best person to ask this question. How can we best screen the fetus for first trimester anomalies?
Hi, gynecologist and fetal medicine specialist. I've been using the first trimester screening to pick up anomalies and syndromic babies very early on and intervene at the right time. The first trimester scan should be performed between 11 to 13.6 weeks with a CRL of around 45 to 84 mm. It is very important that the scan is done by an FMF accredited operator, and we look for the CRL, we look for the markers, namely the nuchal translucency, the nasal bone, the ductus venosus, tricuspid regurgitation. Also, we perform a very detailed assessment of the anatomy of the baby to pick up anomalies. Once the scan is done, we go ahead with the biochemical screening, and beta-HCG and PAPI levels are assessed in an accredited lab. The beta-HCG would range between 0.85 to 2 mom. Anything more than 2 mom should raise your alarm. And PAPI levels should be between 0.4 to 0.65 mom. A PAPI level lower than 0.4 has higher risk of anomalies and uterine insufficiency, placental insufficiency. So that needs to be taken into account. The enhanced FTS is the new kid on the block, which incorporates the placental growth factor, mean uterine PI, and other factors to help us assess the risk of preeclampsia and open neural tube defects. Thank you.